கனிவான பார்வை, நம்பிக்கையூட்டும் வார்த்தை, மாறா அன்பு, இவைதான் இவரின் அடையாளம். இப்பொழுது அவர்களுடைய அனுபவத்தை நம்மோடு பகிர வருகிறார்.
இந்த அறைகளை அமர்ந்திருக்கும் எல்லா அனைத்து நல்லுள்ளங்களுக்கும் வாழ்த்துகள், காலை வணக்கம். என்ன மன்னிக்கணும், ஏன்னா நம்ம இங்கிலீஷ்ல We met frequently since he had to cross our house and then to their house construction site. This made us closer, where a cordial relationship developed to the extent that both families were more of family members to each other, where we spoke about anything and everything without any hesitations. I think Alan was the key person who brought us two families so closer and made our bonding stronger. Alan did not show himself a sick person. The care and encouragement the parents gave him was astonishing and admirable. The parents made lots of sacrifices for his sake. His affectionate and amicable nature was remarkable. He was very glad to be amidst friends and relatives, celebrating New Year to Christmas, irrespective of religion, including flag hoisting on Republic and Independence Day at their house. This habit, I think, he inculcated from his parents. Mrs. Casey, too, was a jovial and a loving person. Her personality and cheering others are appreciable. She was always at giving and sharing than receiving. As the days went on, she was shattered by the news of her illness in 2008. This affected her emotionally. She was worried about family as to who will take care of her needs. And was also scared about her future. She was anxious and depressed like any other person. With frequent interventions and support, she was able to cope up with her illness. Above all, the faith that she had in her God made her move forward positively. Mrs. Daisy was a charismatic person. She took prayer as a weapon to fight against her illness. We all know the sufferings of a cancer patient, but she was very strong in that. In hospital, at the time of any procedures like dressing and any therapies, etc., she always insisted me to be beside her. She will always ask me, So I always make a point that whenever she goes for any procedures, she'll carry on the other part of it. She will not murmur or anything. She'll bear all the pain. I was happy about it. And she wanted a particular doctor to dress her wounds, with whom she was comfortable with. But she was not grumpy. She has been depressed at times. Sometimes when I visited her at home, she will give me a blank look. By that I'll understand that she is not in good mood. So I spend time with her and make her okay. At times, she'll walk away from home without informing the family. She come home, which is where my house was very near, but she come home, she'll spend some time with me and with my children. Enna vishesham appdinu ketta, she'll say, chumma konjam pesi irundu polan vandhen. She'll have a gala time with my children and then go back. She surrendered all her pain and worries to God and walked along with him and moved closer to God. She built a positive energy with her. She did not complain about her pain, but only complained was difficulty for 4 days after her chemotherapy, where she is not able to eat anything, vomiting, and she has to be in bed. She is not able to walk because no food. By the time the treatment was over, another thunder fell on her, that she lost her only son, Alan. Death of Alan knocked her again at her family, but with ups and downs in between, she made herself calm and started to live the way God wanted her. She accepted God's plan. Sometimes loneliness made her more depressed. Slowly, she took up the confidence and continued her life boldly and cheerfully. She understood the speciality and talents in her and moved forward. She engaged herself in VBS, vocational Bible studies, Alan's anniversaries, Christmas celebrations, etc., where she spent the time with the children from the locality, where she prepared the children for various entertainment programs, and the children in the locality came to know about their own talents and taught them good values of life and importance of God in them, God in life. Their family never missed to wish their friends on their anniversaries. Mrs. Daisy was able to do all this because she accepted God's plan for her. During her last days, she was calm, she knew her destiny, accepted, faced it all with lots of courage and strength. Till her last breath, she never had a negative energy. She surrendered herself in the hands of God. The qualities like inner strength, confidence, faith in God, and courage is what we should learn from her life, and smiling face always. She was able to cheer other persons. So let us learn to accept life as it comes and live accordingly and be a fruitful person to the society and to the family and wherever we meet anybody. That's what we should learn from her. She was always cheerful. Though she had all those difficulties of health issues, she was always making herself happy and the people around her happy. And now, since it is her wish, since today's function is on Thanksgiving for Mr. Victor's retirement, I wish Mr. Victor a happy, pleasant and retirement life with good health, and may he achieve all his dreams and desires which he had missed in his life. Thank you.